I know one thing, Pat Brown, criminal profiler, author of The Profiler, My Life Hunting Serial Killers and Psychopaths. I know this isn't random.
Likely is not random, no. And likely the reason she's in that suitcase is that something happened in some guy's apartment and he couldn't get her out of there in any other way because he can't just walk her out to the car. But I do want to point out, we do not know if it's a homicide. There are cases where people put people in these kind of suitcases and toss them. It's not a homicide. It could be a drug overdose that they say, oh my God, she's dead in my apartment. Or there was a guy I know who got drunk, fell asleep. He woke up the woman that had a heart attack. He couldn't remember what he did to her, so he disposed of her body, but he actually didn't kill her. So it is a suspicious death, likely a homicide, but you never know.
Pat. Put Pat up, please. Everybody, prior to this moment, I thought preeminent criminal profiler. Pat, you don't have an accidental overdose or a heart attack, and the immediate response of the friend is to put her in a suitcase and throw her into the San Francisco Bay.
It has happened, Nancy. It has happened before. No, there are cases of this happening before. I can't remember the name of the person, but I remember it happening.
Well, when you have one, then I will consider that to be true.
It's absolutely true, but I would guess this is likely a homicide, but no, it has happened.
I've never heard, she had a heart attack, so I folded her up in a suitcase and threw it in the water.
If somebody
never heard of it.
Well, there is a case. I'll go find you the name of that case.
Good.
Actually, the guy cut her up and put her in a suitcase, but they found out that she died of a heart attack.
She died of a heart attack.
She did.
You know, I don't believe it, but when you show it to me in black and white, then I will believe it.
I'll get it.
Back to the lines. Denise, Virginia. Hi, Denise.